Hello everyone, welcome back to the digital classes of financial management. In our last class, we have discussed about all the traditional method of calculating our capital budgeting. In today's class, we are going to discuss about the time adjusted method of capital budgeting or our investment appraisal methods. So the first method is net present value method. So our first method is net present value method. As we have already discussed that in our traditional method, there was a very serious problem or a limitation that was it doesn't consider the factor that is time value of money. So to overcome that limitation, here we are going to introduce the new method that is net present value method. And in this method, what we are going to do is we are going to calculate the present value of all the future cash inflows into the present date, and then we will calculate that if that project is going to be accepted or not. So let's look into the example, and I will try to explain the method by taking into consideration this example. The question says that there are two projects, that is project X and project Y. The initial investment means the starting investment is 20,000 in project X and 30,000 in project Y. Both the project X and Y will run for 5 years, but the scrap value is 1000 rupees in project X and 2000 rupees of scrap value in project Y. What is the scrap value? As I have already told you, in financial accounting, all the capital asset or long term asset such as machine, any vehicle, furniture, they have a very useful life. So when all the machines or any vehicles are used for a particular useful life, they are sold at a estimated cost, and that selling price is after all the depreciation. So that is our 1000 rupees and 2000 rupees. And next information is also given that the profit from project X is 5000 in year 1, 10000 in year 2, 10,000 in year 3, and after 4 years it is going to be 3,000 and 2,000 in 5th years. Likewise, in project Y, the outflows are going to be 20,000, 10,000, 5,000, 3,000 and 2,000. We are going to calculate that in among these project X and Y, which option we are going to choose. So let's solve this problem. So we are going to add these inflows, calculating or taking into consideration about the time value of money, and also we have to add this scrap value, because scrap value is also the price that we are selling our capital asset. We are selling our capital asset. So this value is also our realization value. So we are also going to include this 1000 rupees with all the outflows. So we have taken year, this is our cash flow, means 5000, 10000, all the 5 years cash flow, and this is present value at the rate of 10%, because the question has already given us that the discount rate of 10%, so PV at 10%. So using the present value factor table, we have to take 10%, that is I, and this will be our N, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, and this is present value of cash inflows. We are going to multiply these two factors and we are going to write in this. So here will be 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Cash inflow will be 5000, then 10000, 10000, 3000 and 2000. Next, we are going to write down our present value of 10%, that is when it is year 1, it is 0.909, in year 2 it is 0.826, in year 3 it is 751, in year 4 it is 683621 in year 5. And I have already told you that we are also going to add this scrap value. So this scrap value is realized after the realization of the project or the end of the project, and the project was going to run for the year of 5 years. So this 1000 is also realized after 5 years. So in year I also mention here same as 5. And our inflow we can write it as scrap value. Okay, so here is 1000 and the present value will also be same as 621. We are going to simply calculate these things. 5000 into 909. First is 4545, next is 8260. You can also use calculator and write yours. And we are going to calculate our total cash inflow, that is here 24,227. Okay, so this 24,227 is our present value of all the cash inflows. Means in today's date, in the present date, all the cash inflows are going to be as 24,227. What is our investment money? That is 20,000. We have invested 20,000 in present date, means today, and we are going to get a return of 24,227. So obviously we can say that this is going to give a profit. Okay, but we have to write it in a proper way. So here we can write present value of all cash inflow, that is 24,227. Our cash outflow, that is 20,000. So net present value is equal to 4,227 rupees. Likewise, we are also going to calculate for project Y, and you will calculate for project Y and you will see that all the cash inflow are going to be for project Y. The cash inflow means this line will be sum as 34,728. Okay. So our cash inflow is 34,728 and in project Y we have invested 30,000. So cash, this is our cash inflow with present value factor, and this is our cash outflow, that is 30,000. So here net present value is 4,728. In project X, here is a profit of 4,227, and here it is our net present value worth 4,728. We can compare these two projects and we can say that this present value is greater than project X. So we will write a conclusion that as the net present value of project Y is greater than project X, so we will accept project Y, or project Y is accepted. Okay, this is all about net present value, means all the cash inflows are going to be calculated with the use of present value, and then they are summed up, and from investment value we can calculate that what is our net present value. And when we will compare with one or two or three project, we can see that which project is giving us a more or greater present value, and that project will be accepted. Okay, next is our internal rate of return method. This method is also known as our discounted rate of return, trial and error yield method, and it is a modern technique of capital budgeting. In this method, what we do, it is actually a measure of an investment expected future rate of return. Okay, So, as the rate of return of a project is calculated internally in an organization, so this method or the rate of return method is also known as internal rate of return. Means the financial manager or the project manager calculate this rate of return. At what rate of return we are going to get a profit, or what will be our discounted rate, as that is calculated internally in the inside the organization. So that's why the name is internal rate of return. In this method, we are going to calculate that what is our discounted rate. Okay. So this is a question written here, and all the information are given there. So from this, we are going to calculate that what is our discounted rate or our internal rate of return. The question says that in a project, our initial investment is 60,000 rupees. The investment is going to run for 4 years, means its lifespan is 4 years. And for all the 4 years, our cash inflows are going to be generated as 15,000 in first year, 20,000 in second year, 30,000 and 20,000 in the next respective years. So how we are going to calculate this formula? What we are going, actually for this there is no particular rate of return or discounted rate. We are going to assume, we are going to take something randomly, and we will calculate that. From that we will think that if we are going to increase the rate of return or going to decrease. Okay, so let's see how it is calculated. Cash flows at various assumed discounted rates. We have written that various assumed discounted rates because we are not sure at what rate we are going to calculate the value. Means we will take all the inflow. Okay, here we will sum up, and we are going to suppose, for example, so this inflow is 85,000, and we are going to discounted each inflow each year with a particular rate of return. And when all the inflows are going to be calculated same as the investment money, means the same as 60,000, we will say that that percentage is our internal rate of return. So this is our year, this is annual cash inflow, and this is discount rate at 10%. We are simply randomly we have chosen 10%. Okay. Year 1, 2, 3 and 4. Our inflows are 15,000, 20,000, 30,000 and 20,000. In 10%, what is our PV factor? So this is our PV, and the PV factor is 909. Our PV factor in first year, means year 1, and that is I 10%, that is 909 826.751 and 683. We are going to multiply 15,000 with 909, and we will find our present value of all the inflows. So with multiplying, we are here as 16,635. You will calculate yourself. Okay, this is 22,530, this is 13,660, and here we have multiplied. Okay, for this much we have already read. Okay, and all the inflows are going to be summed up, that is your 66,000 335. I have, before beginning this problem, I have told you that all the inflows are with PV factor going to be same as our invest money, that is 60,000. But this is not exactly 60,000, this is more than 60,000, that is 66,345. So our rate of return is not 10%. You will not put this mark in your exam copy. So this rate of return is not acceptable. So directly jump into 12%, 13%, 14%, whatever. Let's take 14% with discounted rate of 14%. What is our PVF means present value factor? So with I as 14% and N as 1, 2, 3, 4 respectively, we will get our PV as 0.877, 0.769, 0.674, 0.592, and we are going to calculate our present value inflows, and with multiplication we will know that the values will be something like this. Okay, so let's sum up this. With 14% rate of return, we are going to get the value as 60,595, but still it is not exactly 60,000. This is 60,595, means 595 more than 60,000, means our investment money. So also this 14% is also not accepted. We are going to increase this rate of return also. But as the value is with not more, with a great difference, so we are going to simply see with 10% there was 6,000 difference. But here with 14%, the difference is very less. So we are simply going to take one more rate of return. And here the PVF factor with I as 15% and N as 1, 2, 3, 4 respectively. Our PVF is 0.869, 0.756, 0.657, 0.571. And we are going to multiply this also. Multiply which? This PVF with our cash inflow. Okay, all the inflow are going to be calculated separately with our PVF with different discounted rates. And with this, we will find out our PV as 13,035. Next is 15,120, 19,710, 11,420. And here the total inflow is 59,285. With 14%, the value goes off our investment money. With 15%, the value is less from 60,000. It is 59,000. In 14,000, it is more, and in 15,000 or with 15,000, this is less. So either 14% or 15% cannot be acceptable. So something between 14 and 15, our rate of return or discounted rate is going to be fixed. So how to calculate this? So our internal rate of return will be, minimum is our 14%, our less discounted rate, that is 14%. Okay, so our internal rate of return is going to be calculated as, the first, the minimal rate of return, that is 14%. We have written 14% here. With 14%, this is more of 595, 60,000 say 595 rupees more tha. So 595 divided by the sum of these difference, okay, means 595 plus, actually this is not plus, it is minus, and also here within bracket 59,285 minus 60,000 that is your minus 715. This minus amount is going to be written in the bracket, okay? And when the bracket will be opened up, this minus and minus will be plus. So we can write this as 595 plus 715. And this will be multiplied with the difference between 2, means 15% and 14%. That is 15% minus 14%. This 14% will be written here as 14 plus 595. Divided by 595 plus 715, that is your 1310. And 15 minus 14 is 1, okay. But this is also same. So 14 plus 595 by 1310, it is your 0.454. So we get our internal rate of return as 14.454%. So with this, a project manager can fix that the internal rate of return or the discounted rate, that is finalized as 14.454%. Okay. We will end our class here. There is one more method, that is profit index method, but with that also some theoretical knowledge I have to mention. So we will study that in our next class. If you have any doubt from these two methods or from any previous methods, that is from traditional method or time adjusted method, you can write it in the comment box. And thank you for watching.